In this video, we'll show you how to set up One Home scenes and how you can use them in your projects. We'll cover how you can create and manage One Home scenes in the One Home dashboard, as well as in the One Home mobile app. And we'll also look at some more advanced functionalities catered specifically to system integrators. First, let's talk about setup. One Home scenes are available on every One Home device that supports control with the One Home mobile app. There's two ways you can set up One Home scenes. First, in the One Home dashboard, and second, in the One Home mobile app. Let's first take a look at how you can set up One Home scenes in the One Home dashboard. I am now connected to my One Home server device. I have opened up the dashboard, and if I look on the left side, in the left sidebar, this is where the scenes editor lives. I click on it and add a new scene. I will name this scene Studio Off, since I want to make this scene that will control the lights of my studio. Click on Create, and now I am presented with the editor screen. You might notice that the editor is similar to the One Home Automations editor. And you can also include One Home scenes in One Home Automations flows. We will cover that a bit later in the video. For now, let's set up the scene, click on the scene block, and let's first select the devices that we want to include in this scene. I want to select my key light, which is a smart plug, and my backlight, which is also a smart plug. Click Save. And now the default statuses of these devices is inherited into the scene. This means that if these lights would be now off, the default status would be off. Since I want to turn studio lights off with these scenes, I will toggle this to off. I will also select an icon because I want to customize it a bit so I know what it's about. I can go here to lights and I will select the default icon. Here I can also select if I want this scene to show up in the mobile app home screen of the One Home mobile app. I want to do that because I want to have this scene on hand, so I will also toggle this. I will click on Save. And now this scene is live. What I can also do in the One Home dashboard scene editor is test the scene without having access to the One Home mobile app, which is especially useful for you integrators. So you can test scenes directly from the One Home dashboard. If I now click on test, the lights should go off. I click on run. There we go. The scene ran. So we have now successfully set up a scene in the One Home dashboard. Let's now look at the process of editing and setting up scenes in the One Home mobile app. As you can see, the Studio Off scene that I have created in the One Home dashboard has already synced in the One Home mobile app, which means I can now control it from the home screen. How do I edit a scene in the One Home mobile app? I simply long press on the scene and the edit screen shows up. Here I can edit the scene. Let's try to edit it into a studio on. So we'll basically toggle what it does. Instead of turning lights off, it will turn lights on. If I save it, it is now studio on, and this will also show up in the One Home dashboard as studio on. Let's now create another scene in the One Home mobile app. In the upper right corner, I click on the three dots on the menu, and here I am presented with the option Add Scene. The process is similar to what we have done in One Home dashboard. So let's insert a name, let's do Studio Off, let's select an icon, maybe this one, and let's select the devices. So backlight and key light. Click Done. And since the lights are on right now, for this means the status is already inherited in the scene. This is really useful when you want to take sort of a what you see is what you get approach when creating scenes. So let's say, for example, you want to create an evening mood for yourself or for your client. You can set up all the devices, color lights, shades, ventilation, anything, the way you want it to look, then go into add scene, and all of those current device statuses will already be included in the scene. Then simply click save and you're all set. For this scene, let's change the status of the backlight and key light to off and click save. Let's test these scenes out. Let's first do studio off. The light turns off. And now let's do studio on. And the lights are back on again. Another detail that we also have to talk about is the way scenes show up in the One Home mobile app. So let's edit the scene studio on for this example. Similar as in One Home dashboard, also in the One Home mobile app, you can choose if you want to show your scene in the home view. What does this mean? Let's test it out. So I will toggle show home view off and save this scene. Now, of course, in the home view, the studio on scene doesn't show up anymore since I have toggled that. But if I go into the room from which the devices in that scene are used, that scene will still show up. As you can see now, both scenes, studio on and studio off, are shown in the default room because they are using devices that are in that room. This way you can manage how you control your scenes in the One Home mobile app. For example, you can have the most common scenes like away scene or movie night scene or evening scene in the home screen because you want to have this accessible at all times. But then have some other scenes that you don't use so often in the separate rooms. Now let's go back in the One Home dashboard and talk more about the advanced use of scenes in the One Home dashboard. So as we can see, our scenes are now synced also here in the One Home dashboard, also the one that we created in the One Home mobile app. And let's edit one of them. Let's edit studio off. Of course, these examples have been simpler. We only used on off lights, nothing special. But of course, if you want to control devices that have more options, such as color lights or shades, you can of course do that in the One Home dashboard and in the One Home mobile app. For example, if we add a smart blind to this scene, for example, let's do this IKEA blind we have. Now it's set to close, but if I tap this edit button, I can also set it to open to specific percentage. So I have granular control over what happens in this scene. Let's confirm it for now and let's save it. Now let's talk about this plus button here. What happens if I click it? I get more options for what happens after this scene has been triggered. This is really useful for you integrators that maybe want to automate more things after your client has triggered a scene. Here you can use blocks that are the same as in One Home automations. So a wait block, conditions block, action block. So let's set a conditions here, maybe time-based condition. So if it's after 8 o'clock in the evening, so like this, let's update it and save it. Then let's add an action of locking a smart lock, for example. So we change device state, we select a Nuki door lock, action lock state, locked. Update, save. This way, me as a user, I can use my scene for the studio, no problem. But you as the integrator know that maybe I have safety concerns. I want my doors to be locked after a certain time. So you can add this automation that adds to the functionality of this scene without the user even having to take care of it. But you can also use scenes itself in the One Home Automations editor. So if we exit the scenes editor and go to automations, here I have set up an example automation, how this could be useful, especially for you integrators. Let's say you want to trigger a One Home scene with a KNX device, for example, a KNX push button. Let's see how this looks. We go to edit. And for the trigger, we're listening for a group address. When a group address is sent from our KNX push button, we go to action, we add an action, and in action type, we have run a scene option. We click on it, we select which scene we want to run, update it, save it. So this is a super simple way to connect pushing a KNX button to running a One Home scene. This has been an overview of how you can set up One Home scenes and how you can use them in your smart home projects. This is it for now. I hope you enjoyed this overview. And if you have any questions, drop them in the comments. We'll see you next time.